Our first guest is in the midst of a career-defining competition to become the best film director.
That's right. The Starz show is called The Chair. And here with more insight on the show is actor, writer, and now filmmaker Anna Martemucci.
Hello, hello. Welcome.
You said my name perfectly.
Thank you. I practiced a lot. Okay,
so you're one of two people competing to make the best movie. And this is the first time you've been directing a film. So what's this process like? How does the competition work?
The competition works this way. Chris Moore, producer of Good Will Hunting and American Pie.
Right.
Been around for a while. Mm-hmm. One of my heroes. He gave us $600,000 budget, the same screenplay, the ability to rewrite that screenplay as much as we wanted, complete creative control over the whole process, like who we hired, how we told the story, basically. And in the end, we made two very, very different movies, and America will vote on which movie they prefer.
Oh. Now, wow. Now, why did you take on this challenge, and how did you get involved?
I was involved because I was toiling away in the film business, and Chris Moore became aware of my work and the work I do with my husband and my brother-in-law. We made a movie called Breakup at a Wedding, and it did really well critically, but didn't reach a huge audience because it was a tiny movie with no stars. But Chris fell in love with it and employed me to write this web series for him. And then organically, this opportunity came up and he was like, don't you want to direct? And I was like, I'm terrified, but yes, I will do that.
In the other movie, you starred in that and you helped write some of that movie, but you did not direct that movie. So this is the first time you're directing. And during this process of you creating this film, the cameras followed your every move to capture what that process was like. And we have a clip. Let's take a look.
I feel like I've bitten off a lot in terms of making a movie and also being filmed while making a movie. To me, that feels like a huge challenge, and it might not be the case for everyone, but I knew that this was basically pushing myself beyond my comfort zone.
Mm. Oh, let's talk about your comfort zone. Now, what was the most challenging aspect of this whole process?
I would say probably believing in myself. To be completely honest. And there was a lot of private internal struggle going on. But the coolest thing was kind of like realizing that I can be a leader. I don't have to hide behind someone else being the director and me being the writer and being like, what about this? What about this? This was an opportunity for me to build my own team, choose the people I wanted to work with, you know, from my past experience that I had learned who was good and who I wanted to align myself with. And at the end of the day, I think the show really captures somebody who is highly insecure and then finds their voice and finds their power. And I'm definitely not over any, you know, everybody's insecure all the time sometimes, but I can make a movie, that's for sure. I realize that.
So. Well, now the viewers will judge for themselves how good that movie is. So tell us, what will you be judged on by the viewers and what can you win?
The prize is $250,000.
Ooh, which, that's nice.
Yeah, I don't know if that's a lot of money for most people. I think it is. Yeah. It's definitely a lot of money for me. Yeah, that would change my life. So, and the idea that Chris had was that this is the amount of money that could ensure that for at least a year, I mean, I could probably make that last a lot longer, but I could focus on directing and my next project and not have to take a job as a bartender or whatever, you know, a day job, basically. So one of us, Shane Dawson or I, will win this $250,000 in order to pursue directing. And
now, were you aware of any of the other decisions that your counterpart was making?
Opponent.
Right, yes. did you steal a writer from him and kill his makeup artist?
No, you know, Pittsburgh is it's a city, but it's a small city and people talk. So there was a lot of like funny gossip going around and people would tell me about Shane's movie and the decisions he was making and, oh, they're using a barf machine. And I was just like, it has nothing to do with me. I gotta focus. Making an independent film is a lot of work. So I kind of pushed all that out and made sure to focus on my movie and making that movie, and that was it.
And your movie's called Holidays Bergen and premieres on Monday at 10 p.m. That's when everyone will get the chance to see it and vote on it. But what's it about?
Holidaysburg is the story of four college freshmen who come back to their town on Thanksgiving break the first time since they've left. So, you know, it's only been 3 months, but they're all so different because of that kind of hilarious transition time when you're that young. Mm-hmm. 3 months can feel like a lifetime. You feel like a totally different person. So it's very much about transition in life and that point where it's kind of the transition between adolescence and adulthood. And it kind of captures it all in one weekend.
Which is kind of what you're experiencing now, professionally.
Yeah.
Right, the transition. So what makes you stand out as a better director
Oh, God.
Than your opponent?
Oh my God. Well, I don't want to. I don't want to toot my own horn.
Toot, 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 come on.
I think, honestly, I put together one of the most incredible teams that I've ever seen work together. I had incredible producers, incredible talent in terms of just every, I had this production designer who was out of control. So I think in my, biggest strong point was really my taste in people, honestly, because film is so collaborative, and it's hard for me to even take credit for how, I mean, I think the movie turned out incredibly, and the reviews have been incredible, and that is really because of this team that I built, and just kind of sucking everybody's talent and putting it all into this movie, and it turned out great. So.
Teamwork makes the dream work.
It's true.
Real quick, why did you want, because you were acting before, you were a writer, why did you want to step behind the lens, and how have you enjoyed that experience?
Well, being a writer, I think, is so much about storytelling. And as my career kind of progressed, I realized how little power a writer has on a feature film, and how you kind of, the minute that you give someone a screenplay, it's theirs. It's a film is a director's medium. So it was kind of either start a career in television, because I want to tell stories, and I want to be in control of those stories. I realized that the only way I would have to get over my fear of like being the top banana and telling people what to do in order to tell my stories, and that's what I did.
All right, yeah. So
we
your movie.
We are so glad that you have. Welcome to the world.
Thank you.
Now the show, The Chair, it's on Stars now.
It's on Stars Saturday, 10 p.m.
Every Saturday, 10 p.m. Now your movie premieres on this coming Monday. People can start voting until November 2nd, and the finale of The Chair with a winner is announced and gets $250,000 will be November the 8th at 11 p.m. on Stars.
Yep, so you can start voting this Saturday.
All right, thank you so
much
for joining us.
I'm not going to say we're pulling for someone, but we're pulling for someone.
Thanks, guys. Congratulations in advance.
Feel the love.
Yes, well, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
And we'll be right back with Arise Entertainment 360.